Famcast Media. Bitch.
Some viewers may find the following video disturbing. Viewer discretion is advised.
Kitchen floor, wasting time all night, getting wasted, just so we can do it some more, just so we can do it some more. Here I am on the kitchen floor, drinking my Sailor Jerry's, reminiscing of you. You used to get me so high, but you kept fussing on. Yeah, you sang the same old song, and I say, let's remember the good times, baby. We laid in the bed, wasting time.
Broadcasting live from a secret location in Compton, California. The talk show that makes psychiatrists see other psychiatrists, other psychiatrists, other psychiatrists, other psychiatrists.
Other psychiatrists, it's Sunday night. You know what that means. You are listening to the longest running podcast in the universe. You believe that?
I believe it.
In the motherfucking universe. Yeah. Woo! I just flipped on the light switch, and now the headache is gone. The weed is kicking in, and it is now Sunday night. It is now the pig's
night. Time to wash
night.
My clothes.
It is. Well, is it
I
Sunday night?
I gotta wash my clothes, yeah, on Sundays. I usually do all the clothes washing.
Do you have the underwear that says, like, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, so you know when to wash it, when not to wash or whatever?
Yeah, but I wear it backwards, though.
And plus, you're like, you're a Uber Lyft driver. Like, you know you got swamp ass all the time.
It's,
like,
it's muggy as fuck.
I bet, man. When was the last time you actually washed that car seat, bro?
Never. I don't know.
He's never. It took too long.
But I got my hemorrhoid donut on there, so it's all right. It's all right. You know what I mean?
Do you ask the customers to put the cream on for you every once in a while?
Every once in a while, yeah. Listen, if they don't tip, you know, you got to put in work. If you don't get that tip, you gotta take care.
So it's long distance drive.
That's right. If you want to make it to your destination, here's the applicator, tip. Homie.
The applicator tip. And we give the applicator tip every Sunday night here live on Pigs Radio. Make sure you tell your mom about us to give her the link. That way she can click on it and she can be on El Face. Because all the cool moms are on that face now, right? I mean, my mom's on that face. The curse of the swamp ass, says Magoo. I mean, curse, blessing, I don't know, depends on who you talk to, because, I mean, for those who like
not
to...
my proctologist, that's
for sure. I mean, for those who like to eat swamp ass, I guess, you're in the... I mean, it's good, right?
I guess. I don't know. Is that a thing? Is that really a thing?
Does anyone like to eat swamp ass here?
I'm sure there's someone in the world that would. Not me.
Not you? You sure?
Probably Chris.
Chris? What? The face he makes. No, I'm disgusted. Not swamp ass. I'll eat fucking pig's feet, but not swamp ass.
Heaven forbid.
I know.
He's a foot guy.
This is Pigs Radio, episode 450. We are on our way, guys. Ooh. The road to 500. 500 episodes, one episode a week. We took some weeks off in between here and there. 12 fucking years going on to our 13th. Damn. Come time February, guys. 13 years of fucking pigs and pigs. I don't know where I was going with that. I got stuck.
Period.
Pigs. Yeah. Fucking 13 years and almost 500 episodes. But before we get to 500, we are here trying to get through 450. And I'm telling you, this one episode, I'm excited for all Pigs Radio episodes. But this particular one, I've been vibing off of Mr. Rare Hearts. This is not his first time here at the Pigs Studios, but first time on Pigs Radio. Yep. We had him here. Shout out to My Grito and My Grito Industries. He's part of the label. We interviewed him once over here on the West Coast Pop Lock Podcast. We were vibing really well, and I loved his fucking track, man. I don't know. I mean, obviously, for those who were tuning in the beginning, if you caught it, holy shit, is that such a good track. And we got to talking, and he told me that he can get a band behind it, because at the time he didn't have a band.
Oh, okay.
And then all of a sudden, we find out that it's some old friends of ours who've been here to Biggs. Apparently, Hybrid Citizen is still together, kind of, maybe, sort of. But they are backing him up today, so it's a little bit of a mix. We got all kinds of people here, but before anything, welcome back to Pig Studios, and welcome to Pigs Radio Rare Hearts.
Thank you for having me. I'm very excited to be here, and we're going to fuck shit up today.
Yeah, just don't pee on the floor, man. I mean, you can fuck up all, blow the roof off this motherfucker, but just
don't
pee on the floor.
That's the goal, really. We want to blow minds.
All right, so here on Pigs.
Boy, I got excited. I'd like to see.
He said, we want to blow, period?
Damn.
Shout out to everyone who's logging in. I know we were having a little bit of a problem with the YouTubes. Fuck you, YouTube. Suck our fucking podcast dicks. But everyone who's logging in, thank you for everyone else who's tuning in. Make sure you guys are chatting away around the chats, because we can see everything. The band can hear you and see you and possibly smell you, depending on where you're coming from. Rare Hearts, here we do a little icebreaker here on Pigs, where we ask you a few questions to kind of, we get to know you, we get your name, so either the Rare Hearts or your full, whatever it is that we're going to call you, what you do in Rare Hearts,
Your slave name.
You're either your best Pigs call or Pigs impression. Go.
Damn, this is tough. Okay. I'm from Northeast LA, born and raised almost. My slave name is Joe. He can call me Joe.
Right on.
And my best pig impersonation.
Pig squeal or
wait, wait, wait. Does that count? Is that good?
Yeah, that's it.
I'm a dirty pig.
You are a dirty pig. This little piggy was fucking crying all the way like here with excitement.
Hell
like
yeah.
He couldn't like he kept telling me like, dude, I'm so stoked. Like, fuck, you're stoked. You're stoking me up. Like, I'm fucking stoked. And I was even more stoked to know that we have returning friends. I know we did this once before, but since you're back, we're gonna get another round with you, brother. Let's get your name, what you do in the Rare Hearts, and then that pig's call or pig's impression.
All right, well, my name is Justin. I play bass with Rare Hearts, and let's see.
Nice. Yeah. Nice. Original.
That'll work. Good effort.
It really sounded like you smelled like some really dirty shit here and there in your life.
My laundry.
Fucking
laundry.
Yeah. Sunday, that's right.
My laundry.
Sunday, laundry. Justin, you were here before with Hybrid Citizen.
Yes, sir.
Oh, man. Welcome back. Oh, we're excited to see familiar faces. We're excited to have friends return. And obviously, another way for you to convene and like for our streams to cross again.
The truth is, I'm just joining a bunch of bands so I can get on the show over and over again.
Just come back.
Hey, man. Whatever road it took you to be back in these fucking walls, we appreciate it. So, hell fucking yeah. So welcome back, man. I mean, is that project still going on, not going on? Or like you said, 1,000 other projects. What are you doing, hooking?
So yeah, I'm doing, right now I'm just, when COVID hit, I joined this band called Mexico City Heartbreak and been playing with them for a while. Through them, I ended up meeting another artist named Irene Diaz. And we got to play like the Greek Theater, open up for Carla Morrison.
Oh shit! Congratulations!
Oh, thank you, man.
That's what's up.
We just did the Fort Theater.
Under that same band?
This is under. So her name's Irene Diaz.
Right. Oh, okay. So you backed her up, I guess.
Yeah.
You
so I play bass with her. Right on. And so just doing that. I also run this little up-and-coming booking agency right now called Disaster Party Entertainment.
Right.
Oh shit! And, is it a disaster? Or is it working out for you?
A little bit of both.
Okay, hell yeah. Beautiful disaster.
I found this guy.
Nice. I don't know. Maybe if you have other talent that's like ready to go, maybe they got some shit recorded. They sound great. Maybe we can reconvene and link up and get some more people into fucking Pig Studios and have you back and probably in all the other bands. You're probably playing with them too.
Thanks, man.
Yeah.
Well, I'm going to leave the slider here with you today. But I'm using it right
now. Oh, okay.
But
yeah, yeah.
Camera, man. Where is the camera?
Yeah, right here. Right. I mean, there's cameras
it
everywhere.
It's a
zoom in a little.
Zoom under your chair now.
There we go. Hell yeah. Get it, guys. Get that promo on.
There we go.
Welcome back, sir, with all your 10,000 projects. And, I mean, once again, through the West Coast and Magrito, we ran into Rare Hearts, and then Rare Hearts knew you. I mean, how did you guys come
across? It's really funny, actually. Also,
Laundry.
Thank you to Liz. She's a really big fan.
Nice.
It's funny. So through the band that you worked with, Mexican City Heartbreak, their frontman. Oh man, sorry. I'm so sorry. Their frontman Rudy is also a photographer.
Oh shit.
And honestly, I'm here because of him in a funny way. Like, he linked me up with a cool open mic called Alivio Open Mic, which is really awesome. And because of that, I got heard. Something calling in.
Oh, we had a phone call come through and they got scared and they hung up right away. So, all right, sorry, caller. Don't be scared. I mean, you guys can call back if you guys want.
Yeah, you guys can call back.
They're
yeah.
like, fuck, it's not 9 o'clock yet.
I'm late.
Is it? Oh, yeah.
You know what? Surprisingly, a fun little fun fact, Pigs normally starts really fucking late, but given the fact that we were start about like 9:05 or some shit. So, I mean, we're 9:10 or I don't know, something.
Just in the nines.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Like in the early nines. But all right. So I'm sorry. Wait.
Let's take the call since we don't have a screener.
I know. No screeners here. Caller, you're on Pigs.
Hey, how's it going?
It is going. Who is this?
This is your mama.
Oh shit.
My mama. Hey, mama. Mama.
Let me pick my mama.
Mom, are you calling behalf of the Rare Hearts here today in studio?
Yes, I am.
Woo.
Yes, I am.
How long you been a fan?
I didn't hear that. I'm sorry. What was that?
I said, how long you been a fan?
Since 1991.
This is your mom. Oh, okay. I thought it was my mom. Oh, mama. My mom, Rare Heart. Oh, hell yeah. You know what? Have we had moms call in before?
I don't know.
Is this a first?
Hey! Yeah,
we made a record happen, mama.
Mama Rare Heart, I apologize in advance for all the porqueria you're going to hear tonight. But we're excited to have your son in studio. And any positive words for him today before he takes the stage tonight and performs live?
He knows what to do. Keep his head up and he's rock on, you know.
Yeah,
so.
Yeah.
Thank you guys. I love you guys. I'm gonna rock out for y'all.
There you go. Thank you, family Rare Hearts, for calling in. That's what I'm talking about. Family support. That's where it's needed, man. Mm. We all need support, and no matter where we get it from, even from our mamas and all the family, because that's where it truly grows. Mm-hmm. So,
yeah.
Hell yeah.
We from the hood.
That's. I mean, we in Compton, so obviously you gotta be from the hood. Thank you, Mama Rare Heart, for calling in. We're gonna make sure we talk good, positive things, but there's gonna be a lot of porkeria.
You're probably gonna. It's all good.
Yeah, let the kids listen. Mom.
Yeah. You might want to send the kids to bed.
Yeah, send them to bed. No, Jacob. Hey, Joe, you going to hit this or what?
All right. Thank you, Mama Rare Heart.
Okay, thank you. Have a good one, guys.
Hey, where's all the cocaine at? Oh, sorry.
We hang up on her as soon as we say cocaine. That's a magic word. I'm sorry. I think I was asking.
No, you're good.
How did you come across and link up with Justin here?
So my buddy was a photographer, and he linked me up with Olivia Open Mike, and essentially he was the bassist for his band.
Okay.
And he invited me to his birthday party, which was really awesome, and I met all these guys, and he's like, hey, these guys like your music, send the link. We got another caller.
Oh, yeah. Shit, we're blowing up today. Hold on. We're not even going to be able to get past these intros first, but damn. Caller, you're on pigs.
This is good.
Somebody better be fucking squealing by the end of this goddamn phone call.
Who is this?
This is the one and only, the guy who plays video games by himself.
He likes to play with himself.
He does play with himself. Zach Rabbit Lopez. What's up, Zach?
What's going on?
Not much, man.
You guys are doing a podcast without me.
We waited for you, and we actually started on time. I actually started on time without Grandpa being here at all to help or you to assist in any kind of way. I got sound check in. I got these motherfuckers in, and these motherfuckers showed up late today on top of it.
See, you don't need us to show up early to interrupt you.
I had my fire lit under my ass today, and I knew that Zach wasn't going to be here because he was out there up north doing band things with June Clibus and the Diddy Boys. Mm-hmm. How's that going for you, Zach?
Yes,
sir. Since you're on the road right now, are you driving back? You still out there?
No, we're in San Jose stopping for some McDonald's before we jump on the road home. You know, usual shit.
Okay, hell yeah.
So where'd you guys play at? Quickly.
We did Pacifica, Winter's Tavern. We went out to Avery, which is fucking some mountain town, like, I don't know, east of Stockton. And then we did Albany today, the Ivy Room. So the whole weekend was dope. Everyone was very welcoming, and support was great, you know?
Hell yeah, that's what's up, man.
Hey, this shit ain't about me today. Let's continue with this.
It's not?
It's like he calls in the middle of the show. He's like, but it's not about me, though.
Wait, Zach, are you going to be joining us via phone for the interview? Is that what you're saying?
Shit, I mean, if I don't lose you guys over the grapevine, you know.
Ooh, all right. Well, Zach's going to tag in on the phone for a little while until we get another caller. So welcome, Zachary. We appreciate you, sir. Too bad you're not here. We miss you. Until next week, hopefully you can be back. But Zach is here in phone form. We're finding out right now that how Rare Hearts linked up and touched tips with the hybrid citizen Justin, and apparently it was through a friend of a friend, and then Tinder and swiped up, and now we're here today. and after you guys met, I mean, you got invited to the birthday party. Obviously, the magic happened there. Did you perform?
Before I even went there, like, the homie hooked it up. He's like, hey, I think these guys could play for you. He's like, send me the link to your music. I get there. They're like, we would love to play for you. Fortunately, and pretty
that
much Justin.
That was pretty easy, wasn't it?
It was like meant to be. I mean, and then he has a disaster party, which honestly is great and up and coming. I'm really stoked for him because like he's got a real good program going there, and he's just got a good cycle of musicians that he's working with, and he was able to help me put this band together literally like in a day is what it felt like. Best part about it, I sent them the link to the music. I never sent them one quarter note. Our first rehearsal, they learned almost everything by ear already. Like, it was amazing. Yeah. I was like, wait a minute. I was like, this is
music
unreal.
Savants over here. Geez.
Yeah, for sure. So that guy with the
tone. That's how you know you got a good team, bro. That's how you know you got a good team.
Absolutely. Plus, they're probably fucking weirdos because savants are always going to be fucking just a little weird.
Oh, they're fucking weird.
Just a little off, and, you know, it is what it is.
Hey, Mario.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm gonna get me some McDonald's right here.
Well, they're out of the adult Happy Meals, man. Just leave it alone. Leave it alone. They don't have any more of those. Though.
Hey, I saw the toys and those fucking things, and they just look fucking stupid. I mean, who the fuck?
I'll bring you one.
Okay, bring me one.
Flashlight.
One looks like the Grimace looks like a butt plug with four eyes.
It's supposed to be the Halloween thing. Apparently.
Okay, we'll bring me a butt plug.
It's not the OG.
Bring me a butt plug with arms and four eyes, please.
Mom, I hope you're not listening to this part.
Mama Rare Hearts.
I hope you are.
Mama Rare Hearts, this is what's in the Happy Meals today for the kids.
Oh my God. All right, I'll be in the chat, but I'll talk to you guys later.
All right, man. That didn't last long with Zach. There you go. Yeah. No. All right.
He's all high. Fuck you, Jose. He's probably high. He's all fucking high as fuck. You know that shit.
All right, so then you guys linked up, and obviously he made some calls, and then we go across to the table. I think you're probably one of the first people he might have called, right? Maybe? Yeah, there we go. Who do we have across the table here? What's your name, brother? What are you doing, the Rare Hearts? And then your best pig's call, pig squeal. Just get piggy for us.
Get piggy.
Well, my name is David, and I play drums in Rare Hearts. And as you said, yeah, he called me, and he's like, hey, I got this dude that like kind of needs some people to play, and I was like, "What's going on?" And he was like, "I think you can fit in this band."
Okay.
And here I am. So.
He just called like, "Hey, you want a drum? Are you doing anything?" No. Go show up.
You got drumsticks?
Yeah. Just learn these songs really quick, like right now.
I mean, do you play in 20,000 bands too?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Shit, dude.
Yeah.
How do you guys have fine? Like, when I hear about this, because also Rockabillys do this shit, Psychobilly people, like a lot of bands in the same circuit, they kind of jump around and help each other out, or they need a gun for hire. How is it that when you guys go to your different projects, you guys don't, I mean, are you guys trying to merge?
You could differentiate.
Like, yeah, like, obviously the Rare Heart has his own thing going on. Like, how is it when you guys bring all your different elements together to kind of back that up? Like, do you guys still keep it Rare Hearty, or do you guys now Rare Hearts and then, like, hey, this sounds cooler, or, like, hey, I think this will vibe a little bit more? Like, how does that kind of work?
It depends, honestly. Like, it's, I mean, for the most part, we kind of did it, like, as much to the T as possible for Joe. But, I think, like, that's because that stuff is already, like, recorded, ready to go out and stuff. So now that we're playing, like, some of his newer stuff together, we've been, like, jamming on that a little bit. Yeah. I feel like it will start changing a little bit where we
implement some
your own flavor.
Yeah. But so far, I mean, I really like the flavor to begin with, you know? So.
He's all modest. Like, I think I kind of like this.
It just made me like,
Oh, yeah. Swooned.
Yeah.
Hey, wait, you got to do your pig school, man.
I'm getting there.
He's prepping himself. Hold on. He's trying to find the right time signature for it.
Drummers.
Yeah, squealing 7/8. Squealing
7/8. Yo, Bert!
No, I wanted to capitalize on Justin's point. You know, the thing with that one, especially with, you know, you go into a project and you got stuff that's already recorded, like, yeah, the biggest thing you want to do, at least to me, is that you want to honor what's there. You know, it's like this guy comes to you and it's like, hey, I need this, and here's the songs. And if you come in and you're like, all right, cool, here's this, you learn it down, obviously you go from there, and then to back up your point again. Maybe some new stuff might be coming out. You never know. Mm-hmm. But, yeah, from there, we're going to obviously touch tips and mix more. You know?
A lot of docking going on. That's not gonna get
it sounds beautiful. It really does. I mean, there's no other way to, like, to really merge with another dude, if you ask me, right? I mean, merging and docking and tip to tip, man. I mean, that's the most like, I mean, that's the most rare form that you can be with anyone.
Just
I mean,
foreskin blankets rare heart, yeah. everywhere.
How else are you going to know it's a real connection, man?
That's right. Absolutely.
That's true. That's true. That's how you get in the band.
Well, I can't wait to hear how Chris got into the band. What's up, man?
What's up, man?
Yeah. He's really awkward. Like, oh, my God. Like, no one told me we were going to touch tips and shit. They didn't tell me that show was going to happen tonight.
I just told them we didn't talk about it, but obviously I lied. Yeah.
I was hoping, but I wasn't sure.
I can't wait.
Well, your dreams are now going to become reality. It is now going to happen. All right, man. I already gave your name away, but, brother, let's get your name. Let's get what you do with the Rare Hearts, and then let's get your pigs. Squeal for us, Piggy.
my name is Chris. I play guitar for Rare Hearts, and here's my best pick squeal.
Ooh, yeah! I like that one. Fuck, it's the most metal fucking pig ever.
I know. I'm about to say the same shit. Like, fuck, I got scared a little bit. Fucking shit. Metal.
I haven't done that in years.
So how do you know Justin, and how did you get propositioned for this band? Because obviously he didn't offer you the tip, so.
man, me and Justin go way, way back. I met his brother in middle school. We were homies. He invited me over to jam one day, and Justin was there. And then we just kind of started a band, and
my very first band.
Yeah, it was my very first band too. We were called the Defenestration Act, which means the act of throwing someone outside of a window. It's really specific, but it really pretty spoke sick. To us.
Pretty sick. It was hardcore punk.
Yeah, and we only played like two or three shows, and then just fucking like dipped from the scene. But there's a couple of people out there that still remember that shit.
It's pretty cool, actually.
Did you guys throw anyone out of the window?
They tried throwing me out of the window.
No wonder you joined the band.
Yeah, I like the abuse.
Chris didn't have health insurance, so
he had to call it off.
Fuck California care.
So then from there, obviously, I'm assuming you play in 20,000 other bands as well?
I only play in two.
Oh, okay. What's wrong with you?
I'm stepping up. Maybe not lazy about that.
I know, what the fuck, bro? You got other people in 20,000 bands. You barely do two? Like,
I'm lagging it.
I'm picky with my projects.
Okay.
Yeah, I only join the ones where he touch ships.
Oh, yeah. That's a good qualifier.
Definitely.
He's a quality qualifier. Man.
I got to make my time worth it.
Yeah. D Rotten, all the way from Jersey, D's Coast. He's from the Famcast Media.
Famcast Media. Bitch.
That's so Jersey.
And he was letting us know that the YouTube is down. I don't know what's wrong with them. Fuck YouTube. They're not working right now. But we're on everything else, D. But thank you for letting us know. I just tried to restart that stream again for them. So, I don't know. You guys can check us out, though, on the YouTubes. I mean, not on the YouTubes, but on the Facebooks and on the Twitches and pigsradio.com and everything else.
Be a twitchy
else.
Fool.
Yeah, be a twitchy fool. So now that we kind of got a little bit of the like the people who are backing you up, fucking Rare Heart, man. What's up, bro? How you doing today?
I'm doing fantastic, man.
I don't remember much about the last interview that we did because I like it like that because I do a lot of drugs and a lot of weed. But tell
smoke
me.
Smoke some weed.
Rare Hearts. Why Rare Heart?
I have like literally a note page full of like 100 band names, and I think I identified with that one the most. Hearts everywhere. I got a couple of those.
You got a couple of hearts everywhere?
Got a couple
of
hearts.
You wear your heart on your sleeve.
I literally. you know, as hippie as it sounds, like I'm really trying to come from a place of love as best as I can. I grew up in the hood, so I feel like it was my mission statement to not be violent in hood anymore.
When you say the hood, what hood were you from?
I'm from El Sereno. Like, that's where I grew up.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's pretty hood.
It's pretty hood.
That's like little TJ out there with all their fucking hills and shit.
I love those hills, man.
Did we talk about this last time? Like, that you were from El Sereno?
No,
he wasn't here.
Oh, okay, so I'm sorry. So these gentlemen were here.
Yes, Justin and David.
Okay, all right. Mm-hmm. All right, but yeah, I mean, what do you got out there? White Fence, right?
Shit, man. I grew up on Lock Street, which is like its own gang.
That sounds like it's fucking gangster.
I'm not even trying to like
put a Lock Street, homie.
I think they're like Lock Street boys or whatever. But like, it sucked growing up there in the sense that we had like 18th Street banging. Like, they're always banging back on each other. Metro.
Oh yeah.
Lowell. I mean, there's so many just stupid gangs over there, and I grew up in that lifestyle. Like, I mean,
right.
probably gotta go see some therapy because I could still see the flashes of the fire, you know, from the guns firing at me.
Why do you think you didn't fall into that? Because a lot of people tend to. Listen, you live in that type of environment, you usually fall into.
It's easy to get it.
Dog, now. I'm just kidding.
Down for the rampa.
Nah, you know, to be honest with you, in one way, I was lucky and unfortunate enough to lose my father to it. You know, and I lost a lot of friends, like a lot of family. I've seen them go, unfortunately, you know, and I was 7 when that happened. And one of my first memories is like the house getting shot up. I was like 5, you know, I'm like, I hear like what I thought was fireworks, you know, and I hear my little sister crying. And I'm like, what the hell's going on? I walk out to the living room. I take a turn to the right and I see all like the blinds on the floor. I see the glass and I'm like, what? I see my dad hanging out the balcony. He's like, get in your room. You know what I mean? Like, that's like one of my first memories. So if there's any motivation to not get involved with it, I think I went through enough to be like, yeah, I don't want to be a part of this life. Like, fuck this shit. Like, yeah, I just see all nothing but misery and pain. You know what I mean? And I didn't want to be another statistic. So that alone could also contribute to me wanting to be a rare heart. You know, I wanted to be different than my environment for sure.
And I'm sorry, did you actually see that stuff happen with your dad? Like, were you there, present?
I wasn't present. That was just it was a traumatizing day. But, you know, it's like, it's one of those things you're going to learn from it or you're not. It was crazy. It was like, I was 7. He was going to the Pandusa store. And I was like, I hate you. Because he was like, clean your room. I was like, no, I want to go to the store. He's like, clean your room. I was like, I hate you. You know, and that was it.
That was the last thing you said to him?
Last thing. It was so hard. Yeah, I've been healing on that for a long time.
Yeah. But, I mean, again, as a kid, it's like...
You don't know any better.
No, for sure. It's all emotional.
Like, yeah, death isn't a thing that you kind of sit there and ponder about. Mm-mm. You know what I mean? So, yeah, it's like, you know.
I mean, good thing you didn't go with him because I think that would have been way worse. You
could have been.
Could have been hit. Or, I mean, just the... I mean, obviously, I'm sorry to hear the passing of your dad. And the way it was happening, but I mean, I've heard stories and I know people who are counselors and therapists for kids and, you know, who do this stuff. And it's gnarly how many kids' lives are affected with this same exact fucking story where I've heard of kids get their fucking parents get gunned down in front of them. Horrible, man. Like, I mean, I grew up, you know, so lucky and fortunate where both my parents are still together and they, you know, I have never experienced like true trauma like that, but to hear shit like that, it's definitely heartbreaking. So glad to see that a statistic is not there. You are a rare heart because that's a rarity, man. I mean, you could have easily got into that fucking bang life and, you know.
I was very close. I was very close at one point, you know.
No way. Were you hanging out with them dudes or what?
I was hanging out with my older uncle. And it was funny. Like, he did me a favor in a way, you know what I mean? Like, I was, like, one step away, and he kind of laughed and was like, no. And I was like, what?
This ain't for you, fool.
Yeah, kind of, you know? And it was like, I look back at that moment a lot because I know that that was such a life-changing moment for me because I was, like, just one moment away, you know? And he was like, no, you know? And I'm grateful for that. And also, yeah, like, just not a great lifestyle. It's a painful one.
Mama Rareheart, does she know that you were kind of going down that path a little bit?
I told her this story, recently, actually. That's, like, not one I've ever told her until, I think, this year.
Oh, shit.
Yeah.
So like, she didn't realize that you were hanging out with family being tempted, if you will?
Yeah, she did not know. Like, I moved out at that point. I was living with my grandparents, and my uncle happened to be staying there, too. And so, like, yeah, she didn't really know until recently. And it's funny. I don't think I was really ever going to fall into it. It's just, like, that one moment and that opportunity where someone's like, hey, and I was like, maybe. You know, and I'm glad my uncle, like, the one thing he did for me was literally be like, nah, this ain't for you, you know what I mean? And I was like, in hindsight, so grateful. So
it's
grateful.
Almost like your uncle didn't let it become a choice for you. It's like he told you, you need to fucking back the fuck out of this,
because he was in it, you know what I mean?
Right.
Like,
This isn't for you, for sure.
He laughed. I remember. I was like, what the?
So just really quick, was he like, were you just hanging out with him? Or was it like, oh, shit, like, I want to see what you're doing. I'm kind of interested. Like, was there... peak, or was it just like, hey, I'm hanging out with my uncle and he's doing his own shit, and then all of a sudden, like, oh, monkey see, monkey do kind of deal?
It was more like we would kick it and smoke weed, you know what I mean, all the time, because we lived with each other, and you know, back then it was extremely illegal, and my grandparents were not cool with it, so we're smoking late at night, you know, in the backyard, and his homies would roll through, you know, and that's where like that started to come into play, because I started hanging out with his homies who happened to be more my age, and that's when it was like walking the line a little. Like, I was never thinking like this is what I want to do, but you know, you are who you hang out with, essentially. So,
you know what's funny? I just, someone just quoted me that this year, and that kind of stuck and kind of hit hard. Like, yeah, you are the company you keep around you and whatnot. Like, huh? Yeah, you can't be mad at that shit, because that's just what it is. But fuck, man, Rare Hearts. I don't think we got that answer the last time we were here on fucking the West Coast.
No, I don't think we had the chance.
It's exclusive, man. Nah, we here on Pigs, we do little things a little bit different. We get piggy with it, and we try to get into the nitty gritty of things.
Hell yeah.
So how'd you jump into music?
Dude, that's awesome. So it's like, honestly, I must have been like 9 or 10, and one of my cousins, this we talked about last time, it was like, what do you want to do when you're older? And I was so into Tupac at that time.
Hell yeah.
Like, I was like, I want to be a rapper.
Hit him up.
And she was like, your life hasn't been hard enough to be a rapper. You know, like, nah, that's not for you. You know what I mean? Like, again, like, that ain't for you. And I got into, like, drawing and shit like that. And, but, like, I just, in my heart, I knew, like, oh, I want to do this music thing. I remember as a kid even being afraid of performing. I was like, maybe I just want to produce, because, like, that performing shit seems a little scary. And then eighth grade happened, and that teacher gave me an acoustic guitar to take home when I graduated, because he saw I was so into it.
Right.
And another 2 years go by, I'm just like playing around with it, like, because I love it. And I meet another teacher, and this dude saw I was passionate about it. He had a guitar club, which honestly saved my life in so many ways, because I hated high school. Who doesn't, right?
Right.
And I lived in that guitar room, and he just showed me a couple of like blues stuff, you know, and that was it. I got my first band after that, and I never looked back. I think someone asked me yesterday how long I've been playing, and I was like, dude, I think I've been playing guitar for 17 years, which is fucking crazy for me to think about. Like, what? Like, 17 years is a long time.
Three more years, man. You can consider yourself a professional. 20 years into a craft, man, before you can start, like, start talking and thinking like that. Like, nah, like,
what, is he trying to join the fucking Teamsters or what? He needs to pay his dues?
I'm just saying, like, you don't find that many people who are that into whatever it is that they're into. I mean, you got a lot of motherfuckers who just ride the wave, and either they're into it or they're not, or it's one thing or another. But I mean, it's hard to find people at a young age, let alone a teacher who saw that and actually wanted to grow that. He gave one teacher gave a guitar, and then another teacher fucking enabled that, and he's here, not in a fucking gang with the fucking Rare Hearts on Pig Studios on a fucking Sunday night.
That's right.
With a Hybrid Citizen.
Sick ass Hybrid Citizen.
Fuck, man, that's what's up. I mean, obviously, I'm glad to hear that there are people in your life that care to push you the right way, dude. I mean, because
positive influences, yeah, for sure.
Yeah. I mean, shout out to the teachers who actually do good, and then, you know, not the lazy fucks who just roll in the TV carts and just to watch fucking TVs and whatnot. The fuck,
those are my favorite. Stop fucking.
Yeah,
around.
I bet.
That's what you gotta put on blast for, man.
And not to get too sentimental either, but thank my mama. Like, she was adamant about keeping us out of that lifestyle. Good. You know, like, so.
Hell yeah.
Shout out to you, mama.
Good job, Mama Rare Heart. Was she in that lifestyle?
She wasn't in it, but she was around it. You know what I mean? Like, it was, we're in El Sereno. On Lock Street. Like,
gotcha. Couldn't
really get
it
out of
what
it.
It is, man. Yeah.
She was like, mi hijo no es cholo.
I know. So now with, I mean, when you linked up with Justin, and then is this the first incarnation of this band backing you up? Yeah. Okay. So this is like true beginning.
Yeah.
All right. When you started the Rare Hearts, I mean, would you have in mind to actually getting a band eventually, or were you always just planning to be a independent artist with tracks?
You know, I think I had it up in the air. Like, I've always wanted a band, you know what I mean? But it's like so hard to find people like themselves who are dedicated to their craft, you know, and who are down to rehearse, down to play the shows, down to actually put in the work to learn the music without me giving them a single note. Was like pretty inspiring even. I was like, what the fuck? Like, oh, you learned it by ear. That is hot, you know? And so,
now, like, these motherfuckers got skills.
Yeah, I was like, these motherfuckers, what? Like, oh, shit. And so, it just boils down to, like, I've been very stubborn about just allowing myself to play with just anybody. And these guys, fucking, they're bangers, man. They're fucking pros, so it made it easy for me to be like, yeah, let's do this.
So, we saw a video at I guess, when we first started, and, the music, now I'm assuming you wrote that music, but did they perform on the recording, or is this all you?
No, that was me and a producer I was working with at the time. But like, yeah, it's pretty much right now all.
So this was pre the inception of the band, I guess you could
yes,
say.
Yes, okay. This was like, honestly, man, it's crazy. I recorded these songs like 2 years ago, like right at the beginning of the or mid pandemic.
Okay.
You know, and recorded it. Was like, I know I want to do right. this, but it was kind of like a, for fun, you know. And I was like, oh, this sounds kind of cool, you know. And then people liked it enough where I was like, sick, you know. And then I came here, and you guys were like, hey, maybe you can play the Michilala Rumble. And I was like, oh, shit, I need a band. Like, hold up. You know, and I hit these guys.
Wait, you didn't play the Rumble?
No, I didn't end up playing it.
What the fuck, Steve? False promises right
here. We could have killed it. We could have killed it. Too short next time.
But you will kill it tonight. So
oh, yeah.
Have you guys performed live together anywhere by chance?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Where'd you guys do that at?
Old Town Pub and a backyard show.
Pasadena, right.
Oh, shit, nice. Yep.
The Old Town Pub one was really fun, actually. That was the crowd is really good. Like, yeah,
isn't that where Dave Gambler was bartending?
Yeah, he was bartending.
Is he still a bartending there?
I have no clue.
Shout
I
out to
seen
Dave
a post
Gambler.
About it.
Gambler's well, Mark.
It's a small venue, but I mean, great. You know, you don't need a lot of people to pack it, but you definitely, you know, people are all about it, though, for sure.
The guy who threw the event, which is also my videographer, who did both my music videos, he did such a good job promoting it and making that thing happen. It was packed. I think like we sold 105 tickets that day, and it was pretty much like almost 70 people in the bar at all times. It was like you could barely walk through, and it was like so exciting to play
live
with that. You know what I mean? And the crowd was responsive, so it was like, whoa.
Had you performed live previous to that, or no, not at all? That, in other words, that wasn't your first live performance.
That was our first live performance
as a band. But what about you, though? I mean, have you performed live previous to this band?
Yes, but like open mics, like 2-3 songs at a time, acoustically, which is fun. I really enjoy that. But like, there's just a whole other level and energy to doing it with the band, obviously.
So, how did you feel about it? I mean, were you nervous? Now I'm talking about performing with a band, though. Were you
so this is really funny. I was so fucking nervous. In fact, I was actually depressed. Right. Because like we had rehearsed so hard that week.
You fucking suck.
That I thought you guys don't suck. I just have like that insane perfectionist thing. Uh-huh. Where it's like, if I don't sound perfect to me, I'm just not happy. And I thought I ruined my voice for that week. So I was like, guys, I'm going to suck today. Like, this is like, oh, my God, this is going to be terrible. Like, I'm going to suck. And Justin's like, dude, let's just have fun. You know, let's just have fun. Like, fuck that, you know. And I was like, oh, okay, I'm going to try, you know. And essentially, that's hilarious. And essentially,
really quick, I just want to point out, this motherfucker has headphones not plugged in the entire time.
You know what? I'm not plugged in either.
What the fuck?
Honestly, I just thought I was turned down and I just accepted.
Same. So how are you guys hearing us? That's crazy.
No, we can
hear you, but how the fuck are you hearing us?
I mean, I'm sitting at the table, so I can hear all you guys.
Oh, okay. That's
a good point. Well, thankfully, they're not the best at headphones, so they don't isolate that well, so that's awesome.
That's fucking hilarious. Shit,
that's fucking beautiful. I love that.
You couldn't have waited for the break, too.
I couldn't, no, because I just wanted, like... Wait, they're not plugged in. They didn't say anything. They have them on. Like, you guys are plugged in, though, right?
Yeah. Okay, just
like, we know what the fuck we're doing.
That is great.
They have their headphones plugged into their phones.
They're not even here, dude.
Fuck, I know I cut you off.
No, you're so good.
You know what? Let's take a quick break. Yeah, let's regroup. I love that fucking first track. You can find it on YouTube. You can find it under My Grito. You can find it under Rare Hearts. But then I also saw, without even telling me, a brand new music video that came out 2 weeks ago.
Yes, sir.
Holy fuck.
You gonna play that thing?
You know what? We have a lot more people on now than when as soon as we started, because no one is used to us starting a little bit closer than 9. Let's go ahead and let's play that the first track that we played. Mm. I love this track, by the way. Then we'll talk about it. We'll talk about My Grito. And then maybe in between the next break when we get you on stage, we'll play the new one and we'll talk about it. So, you know what? Before I hit play on this, tell me a little bit about the video. Like, I know you told me your videographer, your promoter, he put it together. To me, it sounds and looks amazing. The production is there. Like, it got my pee-pee all wet and hard. Like,
stiffy.
Because I will say that a lot, like, there's a lot of people that have either the ability to think about doing something to do it or not to do it. And either they overcome obstacles or they have excuses. Right. Mm-hmm. I come across a lot more motherfuckers who have excuses versus overcoming obstacles. Mm-hmm. And I find it so refreshing and impressive that people are out there just doing what they got to do, regardless if you pay for it or not, or if you did or didn't, or if you touched someone else's pee-pee to fucking make this shit happen. Bottom line is that you got a fucking video that looks fucking incredible.
Thank you.
And I know we talked about it last time. The chick that's on there, she's an actual porn star.
Yeah, she is.
Name is. What's her name and how do I find her? What's her hashtags?
Maddie, I want money for this. Maddie Collins is her name.
MaddieCollinsDetro.com.
Hold on, let me open up my OnlyFans app.
She has OnlyFans. She'd probably love that.
Oh shit.
Find her on Snapchat. I'm pretty sure she's banned from Instagram right now.
She's that kind of porn star.
When you watch this video, I feel the chemistry, the acting, the whatever the fuck. It almost like if you are telling a story, and you are telling a story, but like almost personal. Like I don't know, like the energy that you guys have on screen is something else. Like how was it working with a porn star?
So. Here's a funny Easter egg. My ex-girlfriend is a porn star, so I'm very familiar with the realm.
I have
a lot of friends in the
Mama,
realm.
Like, Mama Ray Hurts, cover your ears.
She knows. She's like, when I told her,
she's like, no, I'm cool.
I think she's like really scared. She's like, I don't know what you do anymore.
She's like, okay, but how much she charge for your subscription? she can take care of you, Mijo. It's okay.
What's right? that month? What's that monthly looking like?
What's that monthly sub, Mijo?
No. So it was cool working with Maddie. She's a real pro, but she's also just a really funny individual. And so like, Easter egg though. In the very beginning of the video, right before it starts, and you see me put the cigarette out, in those pictures is my ex-girlfriend, actually, that we did the original photo shoot for the music, what was going to be the music video before life happened, you know?
Oh, shit.
And so we obviously aren't together anymore.
What?
And it's like almost a year later, and I'm like, dude, I need to make this music video happen, because my grito is like, hey, you know, we're really interested, you know, if you have a music video, show us and we'll talk, we'll see what's up. And I was like, that was kind of good motivation to be like, oh shit, I need to get this music video going. So we made the music video happen in like a week turnaround.
Pinchy Migrito. You know what? Shout out to those guys, but leave it up to them. Like, do you have something produced yet? Like, we don't want to talk to you. Do you have something produced? I can't even get a bus from them motherfuckers.
You're still on the bus.
Oscar!
Oscar, did you promise him a bus?
But I'm assigned talent to this fucking label. And in my day, when you were assigned talent, you felt special. I want a motherfucking bus so I can get that bitch out and travel with it and broadcast.
Can I use it if you get one?
Fuck yeah, dude. You know what? I even settle for like if Mike Grito just got a bus for everybody to share.
The Mike Grito bus?
Yeah. Okay, that's fucking sick. I can't even get that shit. So.
Touring bus. Let's do it.
Fucking Mike Grito, fucking go produce your own shit. Like, then we'll talk to you.
Honestly, it was great motivation for me.
Hey, man, as long as you got it and you got something going. Hell yeah. I guess. I want my bus, Oscar. I'm going
to
wait until that
I'm going to talk to him. I'm talking to him. Like,
thanks,
on,
man.
Oscar, let's do this.
You know what? Shout out to the other bands and everyone else on the label. I know we were fucking with Band Hombres not so long ago and the Chicano Shuffle. Mm. And, you know, we're down to share the bus with Chicano Shuffle. Those are some cool dudes.
They're
real cool
too.
Dudes on the label. You know what? Let's go ahead and let's check this video out. We'll be right back. Rare Hearts and the name of the track.
Good times.
Good times. Hell yeah. Let's remember them. I know I do. We'll be right back.
Let's remember the good times, baby. Remember making love on the kitchen floor, wasting time all night, getting wasted, just so we can do it some more, just so we can do it some more. Kitchen floor, drinking my sailor. can do it some more.
Mr. Statham?
Yes, this is him.
I know we talked about getting you on Pigs Radio, but it is a little surprise you're on now. So if you don't mind saying hi to Mario and the best Jason Statham, can you just say, hey, babies, listen to Pigs Radio and Mario 81.
Listen, babies, listen to Pigs Radio, Mario 81.
Before I start the second part of this track, Zach did point out last week that I stopped playing this game a long time ago, and I used to ask all our guests, do you think that's actually Jason Statham talking to pigs? And just in case you guys didn't catch it, let me re-air that again, all right? Here we go.
Pay close attention.
Hello?
It's a test.
Mr. Statham?
Yes, this is him.
I know we talked about getting you on Pigs Radio, but it is a little surprise you're on now. So if you don't mind saying hi to Mario and the best Jason Statham, can you just say, hey, babies, listen to Pigs Radio and Mario 81.
Listen, babies, listen to Pigs Radio, Mario 81.
Damn, that sounded like him. Was that really him?
I don't know. What do you think? Do you think
I think it's him.
Oh,
shit.
Sold.
I watch his movies.
All right, we got one for Jason Statham. Justin, what do you think?
You know, last time I think it was it, but I'm going to say no.
Oh, you're going to say no?
I'm going to say no.
Oh.
That's all right. Me no.
One for yes, one for no. David.
I'm going with yes.
Oh, shit. Two for yes, one for no. All right, Chris, what do you think?
I'm going to say yeah.
Oh, shit. Yeah. Almost a clean sweep. Almost a clean sweep. We will never know truly if that was...
We wish we knew.
Allegedly, it was. And shout out to Tony Martin Blink for hooking that up many, 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 many years ago.
Hi, my name is Patty, and I survive instant death every day by listening to King Drake.
Thanks.
Welcome to PigsRadio.com. We got a lot in store for you, so strap on and bend over.
Ooh. Pigs Radio! Once you come, you won't let go. Pigs Radio!
Let's go.
Sit right down and enjoy the show.
That's right. Once you come, you won't let go. Pigs Radio, episode 450, hanging out with the Rare Hearts. This gentleman is a little rare coming out from where he came from and not turning cholo, because Mimi, oh no, it's cholo. Like, for real, he is. Especially all those goth kids, because those are like dark cholos now.
Oh, yeah, they are.
Cholo goths.
Cholo goths.
That's a thing.
It is a thing.
That guy. No, just kidding.
You're a cholo goth?
Nah.
You like prayers or what?
I'm just goth. Good.
I don't normally hate on like too much music. I'm open. I think everyone should have the forum to do whatever the fuck, but... God damn, this prayer suck cock. Like, I don't understand how this motherfucker is that popular. And I love a lot of, like, dark wave and post-punk and industrial. But, mother... prayers? Like, I don't... I think it's stupid as fuck.
Is that the name of the band?
That's the name of the band. Yeah, the dude's from San Diego. Yeah. It's this reformed cholo who is doing goth music that sucks, like... He can't sing worth dick, and then he's fucking and married Kat Von D, and now she's singing with him.
No, what? She's cholo goth, too.
Yeah, well, she's always been, like... That though, like,
nah.
Yeah, she has.
Kat Von D, nah, dude.
For a long time,
she used to be with Nikki Sixx, fool.
Well,
that chick was like a mean old like metalhead back in the day, dude.
She was already kind of in the scene, if you will. She just transitioned.
Metal scene or whatever.
Like, she just transitioned, but I mean, whatever.
Whatever.
Suck our dicks first.
I don't know. Fuck first.
I'm gonna have to check him out now.
I'm not a fan.
I'm not a fan either. And once again, I don't really hate on too much music. Yeah. It's just like, dude, like do your thing. Like I love hip hop. I'm not a big fan of it, but I love when people get down and like beats sound fucking incredible. They make your fucking tap. You know, your feet tab. They make you want to bag it up and fucking grind on something. Mm-hmm. Like, you know, but prayers just makes me want to go fucking shoot myself.
Like, damn, it just, like that?
It's fucking whack, dude. Like, but hey, man, what the fuck do I know when these motherfuckers are selling out shows?
It's yeah. I mean, listen, there's obviously a fan base, so somebody likes that shit. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Not this guy. I'm just saying. Anything else, but. I don't know how we diverted from the rare heart.
You mentioned prayers.
Oh, that's right. Cholos. That's Cholos. Right. Mi hijo no es cholo because he's a rare heart. I mean, now with you guys performing together, I know we heard it from you, but how do you guys feel about this stuff now?
Be honest.
I mean, let this motherfucker know, like, is it working, not working?
Let's break out,
what's the review?
And we're getting all quiet, like.
Oh, shit. We're not used to talking.
I don't let them talk often.
Yeah. I see that. I just.
Blink, you got permission. You guys have permission.
Blink twice if you're not okay.
Yeah, you guys go first. Someone so I can think FBI. Of what I'm gonna say.
Yeah, hit the power button on your phone 5 times and shit. Get you guys out of here.
I am from the hood, you know.
Ora.
Sure. For real. Like, we're waiting for you guys to answer.
We're trying to interview you guys soon. We're trying to get you guys involved.
Well, your shit sucks, bro. Just
that didn't take long.
It's
that
very
didn't
mid. Take
long. No, honestly, the music's great. It really, really is from top to bottom. It's a lot of fun to play.
Now,
really.
Let me ask you a side question, David. Now that yes. you play 20,000 fucking bands, how is this music different from all the other 19,000 fucking projects that you're doing right now?
Yeah.
Same, different. Are you playing Psychobilly when you guys are rare-hearting it over here? Like, what's going on?
Well, I mean, how do I put it? There's a certain aspect to... When it comes to playing in Rare Hearts, that how do I put it? It's just
you got this. I don't know. Use words though. Try the words.
Yeah,
it fills a void.
It's the tip touching.
It's all the tip touching. I need some right now.
I'll make it easier for you. How about that?
Set the mood.
Turn the lights down. Put the candle on.
He's so uncomfortable.
Like, I'm more uncomfortable with the music on.
Like, oh, shit, this is so uncomfortable.
Like, we're gonna get him tear up right now.
It's a lot of fun overall that you can just really.
I assume you get some amusement in performing with the band, right? In performing these songs, yes.
Yes.
All right.
Yes. It's
do you have to change your style a lot, like performing between the other bands and doing the Rare Heart stuff? Like, is it really different, like as far as the music that you're doing now?
Honestly, yes, in that sense, especially in the change of performance. Because normally, to be honest, when I play, I look very stoic, and I'm just like I may not look like I'm having fun, but I'm actually having a lot of fun. And
are you counting? Like, you're just in the line. 1, 2, 3, 4. Right, 1, 2, 3, 4.
I wish more drummers would fucking count. You know.
By the way, Evo, I don't know if you saw his fucking drum set. That
beautiful.
Thing is fucking immaculate.
Oh, maybe. Yeah, nice.
I'll make sure to get some close shots of that. Zach's not here, so I'll be running camera today. So we'll see how that goes.
Zoom in on the quilted, and like I want to see the curls on it.
Yeah. get that crotch shot. No, man, you got a beautiful fucking kid. I did learn throughout soundcheck that this thing only comes out for special occasions like fucking pig studios and venues. So it's fucking good shit, man.
Yeah, right, exactly. On. And
What kind of, like, if you were to sum up the other bands, like, style of music, what kind of style of music are the other bands you're playing for?
Another band I play in, it's called that's more of, I want to say 90s grunge, but like think of Black Sabbath meets Alice in Chains, pretty much.
Oh, okay.
That's
good. Yeah. Rareheart's track, I haven't listened to the second one. We're going to actually experience that all that together. But your first track does give me a lot of like 90s, like, I'm not going to say Weezer, but like, fuck, man, it has that lazy, like, I don't know, man, like, you want to go do drugs and like have a good time.
I have a friend who says it's called a heroin sheesh, like, I don't know if that helps, a shoegaze e 90s. I was like, cool, I'll take it. I mean, you know, I always say alternative because that's just such a broad spectrum, but yeah, I fucking love the 90s. You know, I mean, like, Chris Cornell, my favorite, Jeff Buckley, my favorite, Nirvana, my favorite, Queens of the Stone Age. You know, I mean, like, I just loved the 90s. Weezer, the Pixies, like, I can keep going.
Yeah.
The second track, are you still kind of maintaining that same vibe, or has the music now been kind of remind you when Good Times came out? You wrote it 2 years ago. Mm. It's been out for a little while. It's been what now, 3-4 years total?
No. It's been out for a year now, a little over a year and a half, and I recorded it like 2 years ago.
Okay. So between two years to now, this most latest music video that we're about to watch in a little bit, has the music changed?
So check this out. I recorded the entire EP together. Stylistically, it is different. I would say it's almost more modern hard rock-ish, this other track, you know?
Okay.
And there's some variants of that, and you guys will see that in the set later. But yeah, in terms of writing, like, I don't know, it just, I think we recorded like 12 songs or so, and then just picked the ones that fit and we thought were the best, you know, and that was it.
And when you say we, you're talking about your producer who helped you?
Yeah.
Okay, got it. Did you play all the instruments, just like I'm curious here, or did you hire people to record all the instrument parts?
I played a lot of guitar. I did the vocals, obviously.
What?
I played some keyboards, even.
Oh, shit, cool.
And then dude, that producer's amazing. He actually programmed all the drums.
So he sequenced all of it.
The drums are not real. It's so crazy. Yeah. And then I think he got a bassist to do most of the bass parts.
Okay.
But we did it together. I like recorded a lot of the bass when we were doing like the scratch tracks and the demoing. And then when we did the final recording, we got like this other bassist from a really dope band called Mattis. You guys should check him out.
Nice.
Yeah. So that's how it happened.
I mean, is there plans to go back into the studio and like
absolutely
flesh out more songs? Now, are you taking these gentlemen with you, or
I'm trying? You know, I don't know. It's
time permitting. This guy especially
20,000 projects, and this guy's like hiring everybody right now.
Well, yeah, they're very busy. So I think it's like I'm very open to it, and we've talked about writing some stuff. And I think like when we rehearse, we've been actually messing around with some fun new stuff that we're working on together.
Right on.
And so I think at this very moment, I'm just kind of go with the flow. Like if we end up making some cool shit, I'd be really stoked about that. And
right on.
Regardless, I plan on recording. I'll say let's cut it in half because there are doubles here and there, but in my phone I have like 1,400 recordings. So like, holy let's shit. Say 700 to like 600 original songs for real. I definitely plan on recording more and different styles too. But for Rareheart's, I want to kind of stay in this alternative hard rock vibe because it's just like we were talking about the other day. It's so fun. Mm-hmm. Like I have other stuff. It's more like. Like Chicano Batman style, or like just softer and slower and like soulful, and I love that. But when I was showing them the songs, I was like, it's kind of boring right now. I was like, fuck, like I like the energy we put out together. So yeah, I hope we make some cool stuff soon.
Now that you're getting to listen to your tracks with a full band, is it different? Is it the same? Is it what you expected it to be? Because obviously when you produce something that's I don't want to say full synthetic because it's still you guys doing, you know.
I mean, a studio vibe versus a live vibe. I mean, I'm pretty sure it's different, right?
I'll say this. These guys are fucking pros. Like, right. we were doing the sound check, and it sounded almost exactly like the recording. which was kind of crazy. I was like, fuck, man. Like, you know, we put in time into it, but, like, yeah, these guys, like I said, learned it by ear, so they're amazing, and it sounds almost exactly like the recordings
right now. Hell yeah, hope we don't get copyrighted on YouTube. and this is number, how many times have you guys performed live then? This makes
full, like three. This will be our third time.
Holy shit.
I don't think we've played together more than 20 times yet. That's how pro these guys are.
Damn.
As we fuck up right now during
yeah, there is a little bit of that now.
Don't worry, dude. Don't get all sad. You'll be all right.
It's going to be great.
Yeah, it's going to be fucking awesome, man, because you're here at Pig Studios. We're going to fuck shit up in just a little bit. Mm. We're going to get set up in just a moment or... and I know we talked about this other track. What's the name of that the new track that just released with a music video?
Tough Guy.
Ooh, are you a tough guy?
It's about how being a tough guy is not in your favor, essentially. If you watch the music video, it's all in there. I get my ass kicked.
Oh, man,
and everyone's
really?
Like, why is the main character getting his ass kicked? I was like, because tough guys get their ass kicked in real life because you're so tough and you're holding everything in and... That's no way to really thrive. It'll fucking bite you in the ass.
Shout out to Bo.
Yeah, shout out to my boy Bo. Great actor. This fool, you're going to see him. It's so funny. Everywhere we go together, people are like, you look like a Targaryen. And he does. Oh, like he does look like a Targaryen.
Targaryen, like Game of Thrones.
Oh.
He's like Thor in Target. He's just like ripped huge.
You know they have like long blonde hair.
Oh, yeah.
Right? Oh, he does? Oh, like, yeah. Sure.
He's a cool ass dude, too.
Does he ride in on his fucking dragon in the video?
Did you have that kind of money for special effects? Holy shit, bro.
CGI a dragon and shit. It's like he could only afford a hand-drawn one or whatever. So let me ask you guys, because we were about to get you guys on stage, is there anything you guys care to promote? I mean, you guys got future shows, anything else on the side? Anything at all?
At the moment, nothing coming up. I think we'll be planning some stuff. I know I'm going to be releasing the rest of the album by December. So early to mid-December, and that means we'll probably play a couple shows before and after that. So I'll definitely keep you guys posted. But as of now, we're kind of just going to take it easy and keep focusing on fine-tuning everything.
So you have band-specific social pages and stuff?
And a website. It's iamrarehearts.com. Uh-huh. My handle on every social media is iamrarehearts, and my email is iamrarehearts.
Spell it!
I-A-M... R A R E R H.
I can tell you didn't like high school.
A R T. I hated high school, man. I fucking hated it. I was like, just give me a guitar.
And they gave you one. And look what you did doing to with it now. You're on Pigs.
I'm on Pigs.
So you guys got anything?
Yeah, since you guys don't talk a lot.
Tell them about your band.
Other side projects? Yeah,
I got my other band, projects? No Refunds. I play lead guitar for that band. Well, lately I've been filling in for drums because our drummer moved up to New York, so. You know, we got to play shows, so got to do what you got to do.
Yeah.
Are you a drummer, though?
I'm not. I'm a guitarist that just so happened to know how to play drums, just a little bit.
Okay, just enough to get you by.
Yeah.
No Refunds.
Yes, sir.
That's what says on the ticket, too. Like, sorry, guys.
Yeah, that's actually why we did it, because we were like, all right, we want to confuse the shit out of people that are going to, like, these free backyard shows. And they're like, no refunds? What the fuck? I didn't even know we had to pay for this.
That's hilarious.
I'm sorry, it's only two projects, right? Because that and Rare Hearts now?
Yeah, okay. It's Rare Hearts and No Refunds.
We only have like a little bit of time, but I don't know if we can get through all 20,000 of your projects. But, I mean, where are you playing at next with any of your bands?
Two shows, actually. The newest one and the nearest one is actually this Thursday at Highland Park Bowl with the band called Deep Waters. And that's more of a punk rock. Cranberries vibe kind of thing.
Nice.
And then another show to throw out there, the band I mentioned earlier, November 12th at the Legion, and also with these guys, we'll be playing November 12th. So.
Ooh, look at you. Oh. Double duty. Have you played two bands in one day like that before? Two bands, one cup?
Yeah, two bands, one cup. Yeah.
Is it gnarly like at the end? Like, does the second band like ever suffer from like you being tired from the first band?
That's a good question to ask this guy, because I've done it with an old band, but yeah.
Sorry, I wasn't listening.
This is like staring at his beer. God damn, you look good.
I feel a little thirsty right now.
I was asking him if whenever he plays double duty and plays with two different bands back to back or, you know, whatever, does the second band ever have to, like, does it suffer or is it ever off because he's, like, super tired? Oh, shit, we got a phone call. Maybe they know the answer.
Check with them.
I don't know. Let's ask. Caller, you're on the way, on the pigs. Shit.
Yeah, we just want to say go Rare Hearts.
Go Rare Hearts. Yeah. Hell yeah. Yeah. Woo!
Is fuck this yeah. Gubs?
We love
Rare Hearts.
Let's fucking go.
Hey,
love you, bro.
Love you, bro.
Hell yeah. Who is this?
This is his brother and his cousin.
Hell
we
yeah.
Love Rare Hearts.
There we go. Fuck yeah. It sounds like they're their biggest fans.
Very fortunate.
Have they bought any merch or any music at all yet?
I'm pretty sure they bought some music. It's my bad that I haven't put any merch out yet. So
what the fuck, Rare Heart? Get some shit out so I can buy something, man.
Rare Heart, you're trying to get that fucking merch, man.
Yeah, what the fuck? Get that merch out, bro.
Coming soon. Coming in December.
Get them some merch, man. They're tired of wearing Raider shirts.
I am too, man. I am too. It hurts.
Just in time for the stocking stuffers, man. I mean, some shirts. Some pins, some right. Shit. I got people who know people who got people.
Like right. Little pipes and shit, you know what I mean?
Some Rare Heart pipes?
We pipes.
Oh, I thought crack pipes. Yeah. No, yeah, get some of that reefer. Yeah.
Yeah,
all right, thanks, guys, for calling in.
Thank you, guys.
All right, so this Thursday, check out David and all the 20 other thousand projects. And Justin, are you going to be anywhere with anything that you're doing?
You know what? Off the top of my head.
You had half an hour to think about this.
I know, dude. off the top of my head, I think we're supposed to be playing this place called Hotel Ziggy over in Hollywood.
Okay.
With Irene Diaz. We're going to be playing that November... I'm probably wrong, honestly. I think November 13th.
So we should go to your
check it out. Socials. I mean, I'll send you a link afterward or something, and you guys can check it out and maybe share it if you want.
Hell yeah, we'll share that shit. And what's the name once again of the promotion company that you have? That is
Disaster Party Entertainment. So pretty much, the goal of Disaster Party is just to bring together a community and kind of create our own little ecosystem because. The music industry sucks. And,
oh yeah, for sure. Yeah.
You know, just it's my goal is just to kind of like have this like ecosystem of like people that just help each other out and you know, whatever we need, whether it be like recording or like music video shoots or just like, you know, people to play in your band or anything like that. That's pretty much what I do. And then I also help book shows and stuff and
right on.
So
sounds like if you got a guy, if you need a guy, you have a guy.
It's pretty much. Guy.
You are the guy.
Yeah, he's the guy.
That's what's up.
You need a guy, hit up this guy.
There you go. Guys need to link up and power other guys up. That's what I'm talking about. Guys on guy action.
I think I got trademarked that. We'll go half and half on that.
Back to OnlyFans. Yeah.
So get your guy on guy action on OnlyDudes.com and then make sure you guys follow Disaster Party. What? I'm sorry?
Disaster Party Entertainment.
Disaster Party Entertainment?
Disaster Party.
Party Entertainment. There you guys go, guys. Get that party and get your disaster on all at the same time. And be entertained. Let's go ahead and check out this new track that's been out for about 2 weeks. Because my grito probably pressured you. And said they're going to drop you until you fucking put on another video. Button, wait, which one?
The explosion one.
Exclusive for 2 weeks.
Nah, probably not. It's already been
2 weeks, man.
It's already got like 1,000 likes and shit.
But we're gonna have a pig exclusive because third time ever performed by these dudes.
There you go.
And are you guys performing any songs that you have not performed yet at the other shows?
Keep it cool.
So there are pig exclusive today. Pig exclusive.
Pig exclusive.
Performing Keep It Cool. All
right, guys, we'll be right back. Check this shit out.
Saw me down, I just break away. Everybody wants to tell you that you're better off without me. Well, I can't stay. Sin, shame, pain fades away. I don't care
Mr. Statham?
Yes, Mr. Statham.
I know we talked about getting you on Pigs Radio, but it's just a little surprise you're on now. So if you don't mind saying hi to Mario and the best Jason Statham, can you just say, hey, babies, listen to Pigs Radio and Mario 81.
Listen, babies. Yeah. Listen to Pigs Radio, Mario 81.
My name is Patty, and I survive instant death every day by listening to Pigs Radio.
Welcome to PigsRadio.com. We got a lot in store for you, so strap on and bend over.
Pigs Radio! What you come, you won't let go. Pigs Radio!
Pigs Radio, episode 450, still hanging out with the Rare Hearts. Now it kind of makes sense because it's plural, because now you have a whole band.
Yeah.
Instead of just being Rare Heart.
Yeah.
Kind of curious, why plural versus singular?
Because I was planning on having a band.
Oh, future-proofing. I like it.
That's
right. I like it. We're getting stuff adjusted a little bit here. We got the pigs cam on. Let's adjust this little, the drummer cam just a smidge.
Damn. Up, no, down, down. Above. Left, left, right, right. All right.
We're getting all dialed in now.
Shoot the fog now?
Wait.
Hey, you know what? You're right, though. That dude definitely looked like a Targaryen, man. It's like, what's his name? Daenerys Targaryen?
Bo Targaryen.
Have you been watching that shit, Mario?
No, I haven't, man.
Oh, well, you're not even familiar with it, right?
No. No. I just know people didn't like the ending of Game of Thrones.
No, but you should watch it, though. I mean, just that final season is brutal as fuck. But, I mean, brutal, it's hard to watch because it's shitty. So, but if you watch most of it, it's fucking awesome.
It is pretty fucking awesome.
All right, man. What are we opening up tonight with?
Tough Guy, the song we just displayed.
Oh, shit. Okay. Yeah, whenever you guys are ready.
All right.
Yeah, you know you never seen me if you think you really saw me down. I just break away. Everybody wants to tell you that you're better off without me. Well, I can't stay. Sin, shame, pain breaks away. I don't care to make you stay. Have no mercy. It all makes me. Break me down. Won't break me. Won't break me down. And I'm breaking down. Don't say.
Fucking rock and roll stars over here on a fucking Sunday night.
Only here on Pigs Radio.
Woo!
I broke down like my, like our YouTube feed.
Hell yeah. Fucking, the YouTube's got all fucked up. I didn't even check because I was kind of running around. You guys have all your monitors in? You guys are good?
Yep.
Okay, good.
Don't let it be like the headphones at the table.
I know, right? Just make sure that they fucking got it.
I don't think I'm plugged in. No, I'm just kidding. We just started?
Gilbert Rivera out here on YouTube is just throwing all kinds of fire emojis at you guys. Woo!
It's my baby.
Hell yeah. Liz Vampire Mermaid as well with the fire emojis. You guys are on fire, dude.
Ow.
I will say that other video, fuck, man. That shit's tits.
Yeah, you liked it.
So good. So good. What's our next track for tonight?
Our next track is called Deathbed.
What? Okay. Oh, I wish I could take back this day, and I know I will. I could reach up and touch me. Oh, I wish I could fall hard for my dreams. Oh, one thing to say as I lay on my deathbed. Oh, I wish I could. Baby, 'cause I know I'm dead. Made a bunch of poor decisions, and now I'm scared. Because I know I didn't reach high. Oh, one thing to say is I lay on my deathbed. Oh, I wish I could fall back in love with you. Oh, I wish I could rise up and touch the moon. Oh, I wish I could fall hard for my dreams. Oh, one thing is certain as I lay on my deathbed. When I'm having complications, we're in need of resuscitation. When the light is pouring in, I think I know. Oh, you know I'm back in love with you. Oh, no, I reach up and touch the moon. Oh, I wish I could fall back in love with you. Oh, I wish I could reach up and touch the moon. Oh, I wish I could fall.
stepping. Oh, I wish I could. Oh, I wish I could.
I know, I wish I could.
That one's about not living your life with regret, if you can't tell.
Woo! I need some of that. I need some of that. Fuck the regret,
man. I regret nothing and everything at the same time.
Yes, we know this. We know this.
All right, this next song is called Good Mantra.
Happiness comes from within. Don't you know you're strong, you're beautiful, your happiness, yeah, you're powerful. If you breathe these words, you'll see what I mean. You're strong, you're beautiful, your happiness, you're powerful. And if you breathe these words, you'll see what I mean. Your pain, your growth, your suffering remains to be the backbone to your imperfections. Yeah, your beauty. Happiness comes from within. But don't you know? I'm strong, I'm beautiful, I'm happiness, I'm powerful. If I breathe these words, I'll be unstoppable. My growth, my pain, my suffering remains to be the backbone to my imperfections. Yeah, my beauty. You can be. When I know it ain't easy, but you've got to keep moving on. And I know it ain't easy, but if you look in the mirror, you will see you are beautiful. If you look in the mirror, you will see.
Yeah.
Everyone online is losing their shit. Like Joshua Rivera, holy shit. Nothing but I can't see that emoji, but there's fires and hearts emoji. Amanda Duran, that drummer though. Oh shit. Jasmine, on here with some fucking hearts and
Flaming Hearts.
Dude, damn. Yeah, Flaming Hearts.
New band name, Flaming Hearts.
Flaming Hearts. Oh shit. Flaming Hearts. Hannah, that bass player. Hearts emojis.
Oh hi baby, I love you. That's my wife, Hannah.
Joshua Rivera, Nirvana meets Soundgarden.
Damn, yes. Thank you.
Yes, I hear it. I feel it.
That's a compliment.
Just don't get all sad, like of course I know, please. Just don't get all sad, man. I was really upset when all that shit went down. I was so upset. Hopefully that never happens to other good musicians and everyone gets the help that they need to get. Mm-hmm. And the only way to release that is through music and with some love and, you know, taking a page out of Rare Hearts and just being positive and not a statistic.
That's right.
I'm actually surprised I can even say that word today. No, I'm like, fuck that shit
Hey,
up.
Zach is right, by the way. We're swimming.
Yeah, yeah. Swamp ass already, right? You know what?
Little swampy.
We were supposed to have Rare Hearts a couple weeks ago, and it was during when it was super hot. I was dealing with some computer issues where, like, the computer actually overheated during June Clivus.
Your computer has swamp ass.
The computer has swamp ass, yeah. And I went to the Apple store, and they told me nothing was wrong, so I decided to buy an AC for this motherfucker. We were supposed to have that shit installed. We're halfway through it, man.
They'll be ready by wintertime.
Yeah, for sure.
Right on.
But it's California, so you know it's going to be hot.
Typical pigs, right?
Yeah. But it's coming, guys, so hopefully by the next time you're back, and maybe, or if you guys bring one of your 10,000 other projects, maybe we'll have some AC, so it won't be as bad. Kill It Boys from the Dungeon Podcast. Yeah, man, you guys are getting new fans, and obviously all the current fans you guys have, they are just enjoying the live performance. For those who have not been able to make it, if this is your first time checking out Rare Hearts Live, I mean, sound off on here. Let us know. Go off. Hell yeah. It looks like all the Riveras are online right now, so they're all fucking jumping on. So
I got love for them.
Woo, as you should, man, as you should. What we got next?
This next song is called Driving Me Insane.
Oh, shit.
You might already know.
Rock and roll.
Baby, tell me what's so strange. We can be anything you arrange. Push me down, you're strong. How you wear your crown, you're driving me crazy. In the way that I feel, can't be explained.
You're driving me insane. You're driving me insane. Whiz is fine. You're making me wanna run my mind. You're making me wanna press rewind. You're driving me insane.
Whiz is fine. Squeeze just for pain. We can be anything, but you push away. Broken glass, so how we clash, and we end in flames. You're driving me crazy. In the way that I feel, can't be explained.
You're driving me insane. Whiz is fine. You're driving me insane. Whiz is fine. You're making me wanna run my mind. You're making me wanna press rewind. You're driving me insane.
Whiz is fine. Whiz is fine. Never gonna push me down. I will play the fool again. Never gonna tie me down. I will find a love again. 'Cause I know that fortune favors the bold. And I know everybody grows old. Oh, but you're driving me insane. You're driving me insane. You're driving me insane. You're driving me. You're driving me fucking insane. You're driving me insane. Driving me insane. You're driving me. You're driving me fucking insane.
Who's that dedicated to? Fuck that bitch.
What's her OnlyFans?
This was before I was in that realm.
Oh, okay, okay, okay. Right, right. Way before. 2 years ago, man. Two and a half years ago.
I was ready to sub up. You know what I mean?
I mean, who doesn't have something that drives them insane, right?
Toxic.
I go insane every fucking day, bro.
It was definitely toxic.
Toxica.
It's the best.
Toxico. I did see today, I was I forgot where I was at today, but on the vehicle there was a sticker and it says little Toxico on board. I'm like and I'm like, what the fuck?
They're just proud of flying that flag, aren't they? Shit.
Apparently, dude. It's fucking horrible. All you crazy motherfuckers.
Well, they just want the other crazy motherfuckers,
well,
you know? Yeah,
well, fair warning, right? They're letting each other know.
Also that. That's where I fucked up. I saw those red flags. I was like, it can't be that bad, right? Oh, shit.
Yeah.
I was wrong.
Learned your lesson.
Charlie.
And in that memory, this next song is a fan favorite. It's Good Times.
That's it.
It's one of my...
Let's remember the good times, baby. Remember making love on the kitchen floor. Wasting time all night, getting wasted, just so we can do it some more. Just so we can do it some more. I am on the kitchen floor, drinking my Sailor Jerry's, reminiscing of you. You used to get me so high, but you kept fussing on. Yeah, you sang the same old song, and I say, let's remember. On the bathroom floor, wondering what should it be. Obviously you and me. I bled all over you too, dreaming of what could have been. Oh, I know I broke us then. I said fuck it. Let's remember the good times. More.
Yeah.
You know, I haven't talked about this in quite some time, but normally that thing I do when I masturbate in the fucking shower and I cry and I normally have a track to something.
Totes.
Fuck. That's going to be it for this fucking week, bro. Like, that is definitely that kind of fucking track. I always want to remember the fucking good times. This is one of the most fucking awesomest episodes. Obviously, with you guys just being here, fucking laying it all out. Rare Hearts here live on Pigs Radio, tearing up that pig stage. Holy fuck, man. Is the entire fucking internet just throwing fire emojis? So just don't get in your eyeballs, man. Don't get on fucking fire and shit, but... Holy fuck, man. I'm excited to see what, you know, the rest of the album's going to sound like. Hopefully you press some vinyl, dude. I think this needs to hit some wax, man. Get some
that's
wax.
That's a dream right there. That'd be sick.
My Grito, get on it. Fuck. Do something. Print some shit. Be a record label. I don't know. I'm not a record label. I know Merchabilly and fucking Lycan's Den Records is a Merchabilly label, and they do all kinds of printing. And
they press fucking vinyl.
Hell yeah. They press like it's going out of business and shit. So
well,
get it. I don't know.
We're going to make that happen for sure.
Yeah. Put some pressure on them motherfuckers like they pressure you to fucking put out music videos. So, I don't know. Just saying.
Do we have time for another song?
Fuck yeah, we do.
All right, we got one more. Remember, this is our third time playing together, guys. So it's a lot of fun. And this one is called Keep It Cool.
Oh.
Tell me, tell me, tell me, where have you been? I've been down, alone in my skin. I bring myself to life, yeah, I don't know my name. I'm here to survive, yeah, I don't know my way. I know I'm on the rise. Well, I can't breathe or see it in my eyes. I'm not empty. I need to feel alive. I need to feel alive. Souls, I've got something to say to you, and I know it's kinda cold. And I know that you're afraid to live your lives. A mass hysteria in here in everybody's eyes. And I know you are, you're just afraid, yeah. You're just afraid. Fear inside your eyes, and I know there's no one there. I tried my best to help you see that there's nothing to keep you scared. And I know that you're afraid, and I know that you're worried. And I know life can be what we want, we just cannot be afraid. And I see you are, you're just afraid. Oh shit! You're just afraid!
lot of fucking fun.
Hell yeah. I was not expecting that at all. I thought we were going to like nightcap with the fucking hit, and holy shit. I know I told you guys earlier that my asshole fucking puckered up and all the hairs, but holy shit, after that last song.
You're ready to dock.
Yeah, I'm.
Totes.
Who's down to dock right now? Who's down to dock?
We're looking for some glasses.
Oh, wait. Oh, right there in front of the pedal board.
Careful,
front of the pedal board.
Don't step on it. I've done that before. Don't step on it.
You wait, did your glasses fall off while you were rocking out?
He was rocking.
Nice. I can't wait to check that shit out on the replay.
He rocked out without his glasses on.
Jinkies. I can't see without my glasses.
Everyone online is saying such a good live performance. Congratulations. Incredible performance. A lot of fire emojis still coming in. You guys are going to be burnt up and shit.
I like the sun.
Holy shit, man. Thank you guys so much for taking time out of your Sundays and, you know, just coming out and talk some shit on fucking pigs and just rocking out with your cocks out. And holy shit, man. I'm sorry. I know. I think we talked earlier. There's nothing set up, but you guys can follow Rare Hearts. I am Rare Hearts across all your social medias and find out when this motherfucker is going to be releasing some merch. Hopefully you can try it for Christmas.
Uh-huh.
Don't get all grinched out and shit. Like, get some merch out, bro. What the fuck?
Support the scene.
We'll get some Christmas merch out there for sure.
There we go. Get some wax. Get some shit.
Stockings.
Yeah, some condoms. I don't know. Some shit with I am Rare Hearts on it, man. Just saying. Just saying. Just
buy it all. Buy the whole
merch store. Buy the shit.
Buy the whole merch store.
Thank you, gentlemen, for all coming down and hanging out with us, man, on episode 450, dude. I don't think there's a better way to cap off that fucking episode on our way to fucking 500. Thank you so much. Don't forget to tell your moms, and your girlfriend already knows about us. Ask her. You guys can fucking go to pigsradio.com, get all your Pigs Radio news, and just follow us everywhere. That's P-I-G-Z Radio, and I want to say shout out to all my Lucha people. Pigs Radio, Pigs Studios, and Pigs Media and Productions are blowing up, and we're doing all kinds of cool shit. So, Lucha, watch out. We are getting out there. We are doing things. So, let us know when the next performance is so we can go out and support, man. We're going to try to make it out to that Thursday show. Get us the information again, David. Yes, sir. Yeah, let us know.
Thank you, guys. I just going to say thank you for having us, and this was a lot of fun. Maybe we could come back some point.
Hell yeah. Sure. Love for to have sure. you fucking back. New album's going to be lit. Juup? Is that the name? Is that pronounced it for us? Juup?
Juup?
On that note, pigs out.
Oh, and now, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, yo, DJ, so stop the music!
Countdown! 5, 4, 3, 2.
Initiating shutdown sequence. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you. You're cool. Fuck you, I'm out.
This show may cause birth defects and or cancer. Void where prohibited in the southern red states. Official sponsor of the Special Olympics. Not really. 2% financing available for nothing. See your official Toyota dealer for recall as penalty for not buying American. This show may cause massive amounts of marijuana consumption. This show has been a joint venture of cock, balls, and ass. Free sale tossing available. Upon request, visit robertreese.com. Sexual relations among cousins is not incest.
Thank you.
That will conclude this evening's entertainment.